You can copy the definition of a trend programmatically using the getTrendDef and setTrendDef. Let's take a look at these two trends. Here's a trend that looks one way. It's got no grid, and this has a grid, and I'd like to copy the formatting from here to here. As you can see, if I select these, I'll select the two of these. I'll go ahead and run a little utility. This is called copy trend format. As you can see, what's happened is I've selected this as the source and this is the destination, so everything that was all the formatting here has now been transferred over to here. And let's take a look at how we did that. We do that by doing the getFormat command. I'm sorry, I said getTrendFormat. It's simply called trend.getFormat method. The getFormat method allows you to get the current format and stuff that format into an object of type trend format. Now that trend format variable is what we use to represent or to store the format of the trend. Once I have that stored here, I can then use the set format command on a different trend. This is on the second selected symbol, and by using a set format and using the argument of a trend definition, as you can see IntelliSense needs the trend definition there, by using the trend definition from this first one, I copy that over to the second one. So we're selecting an item, that's item one, we're selecting a second one, and that becomes the destination. Now if I would if I simply want to, oh, let's say I want to manipulate some of the trend definitions, I can do that as well. Here's an example, I'll uncomment this, in which as I'm copying it, I'm actually making some changes, changing some of the attributes. So let's take a look at how this would run. I'll go ahead and select first one, then a second. I'll run this again. This is going to copy the trend format. And as you can see, several of the format elements here have been changed as we moved from here over to here. We did that by using things like, it's under my trend F. This is the trend format object. There's an elements collection. The elements collection, the item we're interested in is the pen 1 color, the text color, and the width of pen 1. And we're setting that using just standard settings and some process book constants. When you need to copy a multistate definition, that is one of these color change definitions that you can see right here, you can do that programmatically. See, this is the current configuration. What we're saying is that object changes based on the tag sinusoid, and these are some of the color changes given certain ranges of the values. Now if I'd like to move that definition over to here, which currently does not have a multistate definition, I can do that. We go ahead and select the two objects. Again, I'm using selected item 1, or selected symbols 1 and selected symbols 2 to make this copy. I'll go ahead and run a little script called copy multistate. And what's happened is we've taken those two, copied them over, or taken that definition and copied it over. And the way we did that is similar to what we did with the trend format. There's a variable of type called a multistate definition. I've created my multistate to be an object of type multistate. We use the getMultistate to get the definition of the first item in the selected symbols collection, item 1. GetMultistate deposits the actual configuration in that variable. We then use a setMultistate, which takes the argument of the definition. This is going to be a dispatch interface into the object definition that we got in the first line. We use the setMultistate with that argument to impose the new states on that object. This would be on item 2. And one thing that's a little different here than in the trend is this, as you can see from this function here, or the definition, it does return a value. This does return a value, and that's going to be a multistate object. So I had to create a second tag, or a second variable, that I simply called returned multistate. I needed to use that because otherwise we would not, or this function which returns a value, would not have any variable in which to return that value. So I'm not really using it, but I am I'm not making use of it, but it is there so that this function executes properly. I'd like to show you an example of how we can take this multistate definition right here, and we're going to modify that programmatically. We have the, again, using get multistate, I can set this my multistate as a pointer to that, and then we can simply go in and look at the properties of my multistate. We can change the number of states, the color of the bad data, whether it blinks or not, and then individually we have a get state method of this object that we can use to define individual states. So for example, the first state here is going to be from 0 to 10 and it's going to be that color. So let's take a look at how this, or the effect of this would be. I'll go ahead and run this little script. This is called edit multistate, and if you notice, this blinked briefly and that actually changed the multistate definition. You notice the multistate definition now, it's a new set of states. Here are the individual colors and the values there. So that's how we can get access programmatically to the multistate definitions.